Weekly update time with Jackrabbit Wrestling, our first of the new calendar year with head coach Damion Hahn. Happy New Year, Coach.
Happy New Year to you.
Was quite a start to the new year down at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls. The Jackrabbit Wrestling team picks up a win over a top 10 ranked program in Michigan. Before we discuss the win, the atmosphere at the Pentagon in Sioux Falls, a great turnout. It was fun to watch and hear the excitement in that facility.
It was a great event. Sanford, I mean, they did a phenomenal job. It was a packed house, 3,000 people. They had the lights, the smoke, the fireworks. I mean, they did an exceptional job. I was very pleased with the environment. Our fans, our faithful showed up, and it was a big night for Jackrabbit Wrestling. You know, just from all the things involved, from being in Sioux Falls, you know, having the football team, you know, down in Frisco, and I know a lot of our fans were headed down there. So I was a little unsure of the turnout we were going to get, but I mean, they showed up and they supported these guys, and it was fun. It was a good night.
Well, let's just talk about the duel itself. I mean, anytime you can beat a program, a top 10 caliber program like a Michigan, regardless of where you do it, how you do it, that's a nice feather in the cap.
Absolutely. Hey, our guys were ready. We went down there ready to compete. I mean, Michigan's ranked sixth in the country. And were they a little short-handed? At a couple weights, they were. But, hey, this is college wrestling. This is college athletics. And you put the best team out on that mat when you have a competition. And we came down ready to scrap, and Michigan came on out, and they brought their guys. And It was an exciting duel. I mean, up and down the lineup, we talked about this prior to the Christmas or the New Year, and it was going to be a battle in every single weight class, and it was. I mean, it really was. I mean, you know, right out of the get-go, you know, we had Tanner Jordan had to go out there and get us started, and he did. You know, he wrestled a tough opponent, came through with the win. Derek Cardinal comes out and literally just puts on a show for the crowd and picks up, you know, big bonus points for us because, you know, we split 5-5 in the duel. It came down to bonus points, and Cardinal, you know, helped, you know, secure that win for us. At 41, Clay drops, you know, the match to a tough freshman. You know, was winning the match, gave up a last second takedown, and we've talked about Clay. He's taken a couple losses this year. I don't worry about Clay right now. You know, he's just back from surgery. He's getting his legs back under him, and if there's one thing I know about Clay, when the lights are the brightest and the nerves are the highest, there's no other person I want to have go out on that mat is Clay. So he's getting back, and at 49, Alec battled Gomez to a decision, and you know, it was a good hard-fought match. He actually was pushing the pace and got on late, but didn't convert on a couple scores. 57 Swenson goes out there and, you know, gets bonus points for us. Wrestled a good hard-fought match, scored, you know, scored when he needed to, and racked up the points. And again, another bonus point win at 65. You know, we drop at 65 to a top ranked, you know, a recruit coming in. Good match. It came down to the wire. At 74 was the marquee matchup, you know, with DeVos and Griffith. And, you know, we were ranked, I think, one spot ahead of Griffith. It's kind of odd, but, you know, we were undefeated. He had one loss in the season. We dropped that one in overtime. And, you know, DeVos is right there. We know how good he is. We talk about him all the time. And, you know, he's right there. He can win a national title. There's no doubt in my mind. At 84 was another marquee matchup for us because, you know, we got Bennett Berge, you know, back in the lineup and healthy and wrestling. He wrestled an 11th-ranked guy in the country, and he went out there and smashed him. I mean, I don't remember the score, but it was bonus points, and he looked great on Thursday night. So we pick up that win, another bonus point win, and then, you know, one of our anchors, Tanner Sloan, goes out there and does what he does, and he texts the guy. I don't know if it was the first or the second period, but secured the win for us. And then Rasmussen goes out and wrestles, you know, a top-ranked heavyweight in the country, and we dropped that match. You know, he fought. You know, he was in there. I mean, this guy is in his sixth year and a couple-time All-American. And so all in all, I love the effort out of our guys. They didn't care who stepped on the mat. They had a job to do, and that's what they did. And so we came away with the win. I think they were ranked sixth in the country. That's huge, not only for the guys that competed, but overall for our program, because it shows the country, you know, hey, listen, you know, South Dakota State, you know, a mid-major that is out there, and they're willing to, you know, toe the line and beat these big programs. And so I'm excited for our guys. It was a big win for our program, and now we move forward and we take on the next competitors.
Don't want to overlook a couple of the performances, because obviously a guy like Tanner Sloan has demolished many an individual in his day, but let's talk about Bennett Berge in particular. I thought that win really stood out.
It was a good win. I mean, it really was. You got a guy, Bullock from Michigan, who has beaten some good guys this year. I mean, heck, he's ranked 11th, 12th in the country. You know, it was another test, because, you know, a couple weeks ago, you know, Bennett wrestled Pinto at Nebraska and drops a close match, and Pinto's a top five ranked guy. This was good because it gave Bennett the opportunity to go out there in front of a packed house and do what he does. You know, he's feeling good. He wrestled extremely well. His leg attacks were good. His re-attacks were good. And it was a fight. I mean, the guy did not back down. You know, even when Bennett was putting those points on the board, the guy stayed in there and fought. And so it was a challenge, and he stepped up to the challenge and wrestled extremely well. That's the Bennett that, you know, is a two-time world medalist. And if he continues on this path, I mean, I think he's one of the best in the country. You know, he can be on that podium. And I know that's what he's expecting. And, you know, that's what we think. And so it was a good night for a lot of our guys.
Another one of those is Cardinal. Seems like his confidence continues to grow.
Cardinal has made a big, I don't even want to say jump, because it's really a change in his mindset, really. You know, he's been able to compete with some of the best guys out there. Nothing has really changed technically. It is his mindset. And when he steps on the mat, you know, the confidence that he has and his abilities to do what he knows he can do, I think that's where the change has happened. And he goes out and literally from whistle to whistle, he got on the attack, stayed on the attack, and ends up getting the pin. And so for him, it's just building confidence every time he goes out there. And nothing really changes with the technical side. It's a matter of doing what he does at a very high level and being consistent. And he's doing that. And so that's extremely awesome to see him have that change and really see some of the fruits of the labor, because he works extremely hard. All these guys do. They work extremely hard in the room and outside the room. And so when it starts to come together, it's great to see. I mean, it really is. And he's doing that.
So following up that big win, now you head out to Virginia this week for the Hampton Duels. And because of some scheduling issues, we're still not sure exactly who you're going to wrestle. But this is a big weekend to continue the improvement in the slope that your squad is on as far as that upward trajectory.
Yeah, this is how we designed our schedule, right? You get back from the new year, and then, I mean, it's full steam ahead. And these matches, these tournaments, these duels are super important, not only for the program, but for the individuals, because it sets them up to, you know, have what they need going into postseason. We want to give our guys the most opportunity to qualify for the national tournament, and that's why these duels are important. And so we leave Thursday, and we're still trying to navigate and figure some things out. There might be some changes, but we leave Thursday and we compete Friday, Saturday. We'll see who that's going to be against. I know there's a schedule out there. Well, that schedule is going to change a little bit, but Yeah, it's exciting because I love, and we've talked about this, I love getting on the road. I love getting on the road with our guys. You know, you hit the road, you get to bond, and you got your team, and it's just a different environment. And so we'll head down there on Thursday. We'll get ready to scrap on Friday and hopefully Saturday. And there should be some, individually, there should be some really good matches. Overall, you know, I think our guys, we expect to go down there and take care of business. You know, I think that's what the game plan is. But individually, there's going to be some key matchups throughout the teams that hopefully we do wrestle. And it should be a good weekend.